Test. Let's see here.
Is this the microphone?
Hello, hello. Hello.
Test, 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 test.
it to her every single night. Come on, pass the poo-poo, send it to Papa. Shake it, baby, shake it, don't stop her. Let me see you do the booty hop, and now make the booty stop. Now drop and do the booty rock. The way you're shaking your grills, Willie Kill is making brothers up a whole lot of bills. But I ain't into tricking, just the treating, and I ain't into treating every trick that I'm eating. Yeah, shake it, baby, shake it down, shake it like that.
All I wanna do is on my zoom, 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 and a boom, boom.
Just shake your mind.
All I wanna do is on my zoom, 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 and a boom, boom.
Just shake your mind.
All I wanna do is on my zoom, 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 and a boom, boom.
Just shake your mind.
All I wanna do is on my zoom, 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 and a boom, boom.
Just shake your mind.
Check, baby, check, baby, 1, 2, 3, 4. Check, baby, check, baby, 1, 2, 3. Check, baby, check, baby, 1, 2. Check, baby, check, baby.
To the We can't hear you.
Okay, let's double check it now. Now it's 11:05, live from the Beehive. Can you guys hear us this time?
Yeah.
Yeah? Woo! Okay, all right. Awesome. All right, so two quick questions. What kind of birds stick together?
Birds of a feather flock together.
Birds of a feather?
Birds of a feather
flock together. That's right? But how about Velcros?
Oh.
All right.
Sticky situation.
Yeah, right. So I was at the beach and there was a hippie out there and it was drowning. How come the lifeguard didn't save the hippie? Because he was far out, man. Right, got it, Dave. Right, I can't pull one past Reich. Oh, you said it. I thought it was Reich. Okay, I heard it from the corner. All right, awesome. All right, so, hey, we had some people go above and beyond this past week, take extra time out of their schedule. They came up on a Sunday here, and to do something unselfish, they took the scripts that we had, and we filmed them for everybody to use in the agency. We put 10 of those together this week, and it came together fairly well. But I just wanted to thank the people that went above and beyond and did that, which was our managers, Gio, Drew was up here, Casey was up here, Vince was up here. And most importantly, guys, the guy who was behind the scenes doing all the aftermath, he was here for it. But after you were done spitting your script, you got to go back to your office. He had to go back and edit all this stuff, man. So give it up to Ryan Haynes as well, guys, for taking some time, energy, and effort. Literally going out of his way from the good of his own heart, taking his talent and skills from video editing and hook these videos up. So if you look at them, they're very nice. They're pretty crisp, pretty clear. We're going to keep working on improving those, and we have a lot more to come. So I'm really excited about that. I think I mentioned that on Friday at the workshop as well. But we have an app that's being worked on. These videos will be on the app. We're working on trying to just integrate everything to just be that one-stop shop where we could all stay connected. Speaking of staying connected, make sure we're staying connected through social media as well. So if you're on social media, Instagram, Facebook are the two big ones that we're using in our agency. So if you can follow the agency on Instagram, Facebook, if you see some posts, go ahead and click the like button on them. Maybe make a comment or something and keep our social media game live. We're going to continue to improve on that. We're going to be hiring social media teams. Everybody in here is going to be a social media superstar whenever we're done with this thing. Okay. Why not? They say that if you wanted to put an ad on the Super Bowl and promote your business, why do people pay money and put ads on the Super Bowl to promote their business? Because there's value in it, right? And people fight for that prime time spot. But how much does it cost for us to promote ourselves on social media? It doesn't cost nothing, right? So sometimes people feel like, oh, I don't want to promote myself. It's kind of shameless or, you know, shame or whatever, however you want to think about it. Just take a look out there at all the most successful businesses out there. They're utilizing promoting their own businesses. So we have free business promotion going on online right now. You can promote your business for free, and we could all integrate into one sort of network where, you know, when Reich posts something, we all share it. Boom, now all my network is seeing who Reich is. And Daquan posts something, we all share it. We all like it. We all comment on. Now that network is spreading, right? And before you know it, we're gonna have the social media team up here, and they're gonna be able to help us even make it more cohesive, okay? And they're gonna be able to put the finishing touches on it to make it even look more professional as well. So, anyways, We have an agency YouTube. That's where the training videos are going to be until the app comes out. So you could just dive right into that. All right. Schedule. Got a good schedule for us. Great schedule over the next. Let's just stick to the next 2 weeks for now. The schedule for the next 2 weeks is tomorrow. We have Theo Pappas speaking to us live from New York City. This guy has been with the company for 20 some years. He's was the top SGA in the whole entire world 2 years ago, number one SGA. And we're right now in a competition for, they 2 years ago, they came up with an SGA fantasy draft. They took the top seven SGAs and they drafted all the other SGAs and made a team. And they're basically combining all their production together, and whoever wins over this month is like the top four teams out of the top seven go to the playoffs in October. So right now, guys, after 2 weeks with this competition, Theo Pappas is our captain as well. We're in fourth place right now. So we're in the top four. If the contest ended today, we would make the playoffs for October with Theo Pappas. He's our captain. Oh, yeah. So Theo Pappas is our captain. He's going to speak to us tomorrow at 9 a.m. Our time, which would be 10 a.m. his time. He's going to be Eastern time. So 9 a.m. Central time, will that be? But Theo's going to speak to the managers at 9, and then he's going to speak to the whole agency at 9:30. So the agency can hop on at 9:30. He's the man. He actually, right at the beginning of this thing, came down with, I think he was the first person I ever heard. He came down with it was major pneumonia, or it could have been COVID. I didn't really hear the final, but he was bad, like bad shape, and he fought through it, and now his agency is actually rocking. He has one of the top RGAs in the world. So anyways, Theo's going to speak to us. I'll announce everybody a little bit later. Let's just go through the schedule. So we got Theo, 9 o'clock on Tuesday for the managers, 9:30 for everyone else. Just hop on the Zoom link. It'll be sent out there to you. So mark your schedule tomorrow, 9:30. Definitely want to hop on that call. We got Wednesday, 9 a.m. We'll do sales training. So if you want to hop on some sales training, Wednesday, 9 a.m. sales training. I ran it on Friday. We went over discount cards and some stuff like that. And then also Friday, we got 9 a.m. sales training. So this week, Wednesday and Friday, 9 a.m. sales training. If you want to sharpen up that saw, right? What do they say about sharpening your saw? That's what the seventh habit. Seventh habit is sharpen the saw. Seventh habit is sharpen the saw. So the group this week. So let's stay on this week. We are going to be hosting the group on Tuesday, Wednesday, and Thursday at 11 a.m. So if you have friends, family members, personal recruits, somebody that you just met, or anybody that you want to introduce to the company and the career, we'll be hosting those Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday at 11 a.m., but we're also going to do one on Wednesday night at 6 p.m. So if you have someone that wants to check out the career opportunity, but they're absolutely slammed all week, we have that special slot Wednesday night as well, where you can have them sit in on the company overview. So mark your calendars for that. Next week, though, let's go into next week. 1 week from today, it's going to be August 3rd. We're going to kick off our agency meeting, and we're going to have a special guest speaker who's going to speak to us, and he's also going to be coming to visit our agency at the end of the month. So I wanted to get us a dose now so that we can get familiar, and then at the end of the month, he's going to come visit. That's going to be Simon Arias. Simon's our founder. He's like my brother in this business. He brought me in, 12 years ago. That's where we all come from. So I figure, why not have our father in the business, come speak to us and give us an idea of where we're from, and give us an idea of the bloodline that we're from. So we actually know, what's pumping through our veins right now. I'll go into it right now, actually. The company, let's talk about American Income Life. Has been around for how long? 70. Almost 70 years. We were founded in 1951. So this will be our 69 years. At the end of this year, we'll finish our 70-year anniversary, right? So 1951 to 2020, almost 70 years. We had three CEOs in company history. The founder of our company, Bernard Rappaport founded this company. He was the CEO for more than half this company. more than 35 years, 40 years. He is the founder and CEO of the company. And he taught everything he could, and he spent a lot of time with this guy named Jim Cerace. Jim Cerace was the state director for Ohio. Jim Cerace learned this company from the guy who built the company, right? And Jim Cerace partnered with Marcus Smith. Today it's called the Cerace Smith Organization, and they've now expanded, and they have a large influence in the company. So what was it, about 15 years ago, Simon graduated from college. You know, when he's 21, 22 years old. He went straight to work with American Income Life for Cerace Smith. So that was where he worked for his first 3 years in the company. At by age of 24, he was the youngest, most successful regional director and managing director in the whole entire company by age of 24. They had no choice. They promoted him to a state director. So now he's 24 years old. He goes to take over his own state. He took over the state of Pennsylvania. He started right smack dab in Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania. At that time, I was a financial advisor. I met Simon. I left my career. I came here 12 years later. Now here we are. So over the last 12 years, me and Simon worked together. We pretty much built, broke, and shattered every single record in company history. So the bloodline of our company goes like this. Think about it. It goes Bernard Rapoport, Jim Cerace, Simon Arias, us. We can't have a closer connection to the core of really the heartbeat of really what this company was about. I mean, how much closer, talk about 3 degrees of separation, like how much closer could we be to the founder of the company, if you think about it, right? So he's gonna come visit us at the end of the month as well, but he's gonna speak on our meeting next week as well. If you wanna get familiar, you can check out Simon, look on Instagram, YouTube, Facebook. You can just follow him on all that stuff, and he's all over the place. Yeah. What's that?
It's his birthday.
And it's his birthday today. So shout out Si, if you ever saw him, obviously not watching, but happy birthday, man. Well, but his birthday is today as well. So anyways, what do we got? Next week, Monday, Simon. Tuesday, 9 a.m. sales training. Wednesday, Justin Adams at 9 a.m. If you pull up the Spotlight magazine right now, last month, if you go every month in the Spotlight, they show the top producers, they show the top supervisors, the top managers, the top general managers for the month, and the top regional managers for the month. So we're gonna have on Wednesday next week, this guy was number one in his category last month. Justin Adams, he's gonna be speaking to us live on Wednesday next week at 9 a.m., okay? So we're gonna have him speak. And then he's also coming to visit us the week before Labor Day. He'll be visiting us that Friday. He's gonna come stay with us for the weekend, but he's coming up Thursday night just so he can be here with us Friday. He was gonna drive Friday. And I said, when you come up, can you come up Thursday? Because if you come up Thursday, then we can hit the office on Friday. He's like, all right, that'll probably work better anyways. The kids can just sleep. So he's going to come up early on Thursday night just so he can spend time with us on Friday, the weekend before the Friday before Labor Day. Okay. So Justin's coming up here for that as well. And then, so anyways, that's the schedule for next week. Tuesday, 9 a.m. sales training. Wednesday, 9 a.m. Justin Adams. That's the 5th. So mark the 5th for 9 a.m. so you can have time with Justin. And then we'll wrap up the week on Friday again with the 9 a.m. sales call, just to close out the week, give us something to work with. All right. So let's go over the schedule, guys. Here's where we're at today. Today would technically be the last Monday of the month. We could end our month today and start August. But if you look at the schedule provides for us to do something special. We don't always get this opportunity. And even if we do, we don't always have to take advantage of it. But if you look at the schedule, July ends on the 31st. And the 31st is when? Friday. So if we wanted to, we can take the business that we write today, tomorrow, and Wednesday, and we can send that Thursday, and it'll still count for the month of July. Or we end the month today and then we just take all the business that we write and just move it into August, right? We're close. We got a lot of people pushing. A lot of people got a lot of momentum. A lot of us have worked pretty hard to get to their highest bonus level of the month. So if you can go out over the next 3 days and add to your bonus level for July, we as managers have made the executive decision that we want to push July 3 more days and run this sucker and empty the clip and give it all we got and just put everything we got into the month of July from now until Thursday. Okay. So we're going to push the month. We're going to push it. I don't really want to do that, but we have the opportunity to do so. So this is going to allow us to crush our goals for July. This gives everybody an extra half a week to get where they want to be. And if you're not where you want it to be, there you go. You got an extra half a week. If you are where you want to be, let's add some extra to it and put some icing on the cake. All right. So that's going to allow us also to put more business on for the SGA competition. So we're going to be able to perform for the SGA competition. I'm competitive. I want to make sure that our agency performs and we're not the one who didn't step up during competition. And also, guys, we're pushing for the vacation. Agency got to do 120,000 for the month to hit the vacation. So we got a big push over the next few days. We're going to have to do about 15,000 a day for the next 3 days is what we're going to need to get it done. So we can do it. We can do it. We've done it over the past few weeks. We've hit a couple $15,000 days. So we're going to have to string together now like 3 days in a row of some major push, but we can push and close out the month. And here's regardless of what happens, if we push and we don't crush 120,000 for the month and we end up a little bit short, what we did is we gained the momentum that we're not letting down in August. So one thing I can tell everyone here is that we are not slowing down in August. If we're doing anything, we're speeding it up. So if you think you're running fast now, just get ready. We're going to ask you to run faster in August. You know, if you think you made a lot of phone calls now, we're going to have to make more phone calls in August, right? If you think you're running a pretty disciplined schedule now, we're going to have to get more disciplined into our schedule in August. If you listen to the Eric Thomas that we posted this morning, he talks about all the rich people. You know, if you met Eric Thomas, I met Eric Thomas. Eric Thomas and his kid drove around in my Maserati in the parking lot in our office. Anybody know E.T.? Anybody know Eric Thomas? Okay, get familiar with Eric Thomas. He's the number one motivational speaker in the world right now. You turn on the NBA playoffs and he's announcing the NBA playoffs commercials on TNT, you know? But he come and visit our agency. We spent $10,000. He flew to our agency to speak to us. And him and his crew were all there and his kids and everybody. And they were driving around in Simon's Bentley. He wanted to drive the Maserati. I let him drive the Maserati with his kid. So Eric Thomas is the man. And we see him when he started out, when he was charging $10,000 for an engagement. Now, if you want to get him, it's 50 to 100. We're grandfathered in though. We made a deal with him. We said, no matter how big you get, you better keep us at the grandfather rate. So we could still call him, you know, and everything, and he'd hook it up. But anyways, he said that over time, he's been exposed to a lot more millionaires than he ever has been in his life over the past 5 years. And one thing that he learned is that millionaires don't mess around with their time. They don't mess around with their time. They don't waste their time. Like they're not even that into entertainment. Like if they're at a basketball game, it might be to watch the game, but it's probably also there because there's some business reason behind it. You know, maybe they're, and if they're there, they're not just watching the game. They're learning how, they're watching like something, they're doing something. So that's one thing that he said is that we have to be more disciplined with our scheduling of our time. A lot of people don't take time to plan. And I think that's where we can all improve on, even myself, is taking more time to plan. Cause I think like we're such a doer. I'm a doer. You know, I want to be doing. So if I'm not doing, I feel like I'm not doing anything. If I'm not doing something, I feel like I'm not doing anything. But sometimes you don't need to be doing something. You need to be planning on what you're going to be doing, you know? So what do they say? That most people don't plan to fail. they actually failed a plan, right? And you can say that every single client that you ever meet with for the rest of your life, you can literally say that too, and you probably should. I can't think of many clients that I have not said that to. And I can't think of many of them that didn't agree with me immediately after. You know, Joe and Mary, most families that we meet with, most people, they don't plan to fail. What we find is those that they fail the plan, right? And they'll be like, oh yeah, that makes sense, right? So that's why they came up with this plan for you and your family, Joe. They call this the family plan for the family man. This is the union plan for the family man, you know? So anyways, and that's what I would say to the clients in the home. You always should be saying that. But let me ask you this. Most people don't plan to fail. They fail to plan. Why? Because they never planned on when they're going to plan. Why'd they fail to plan? Like, think about it. Why would somebody fail to plan? Because they never put in their schedule on when they were going to plan. Like, if I asked you, what time of day during the week do you do all your planning? You know, like what is it? Is it, do you have a schedule where you planned on when you're going to do your planning? You know, most people don't have a plan on when they're going to plan. So then the whole week goes by and guess what they never did? We never planned on nothing. We just kept on just doing, going through the motions, working, trying to work really, really hard. But if we just take a little bit of time to figure out where we're at, where we need to go, and then gain a little bit of direction here and there, we can control some of that doing a little bit more and do more results. So sometimes they say that, you know, there's two things you can think about. Well, if you had 8 hours to chop down a tree, I spent at least two of them sharpening my axe, right? Well, it's the same thing with your schedule. If you got, you know, 168 hours in a week, can we spend two of them to figure out the other 166, right? Otherwise, we're not getting as much out of it. You're running around kind of like a doll. It's like a doll thing. You're swinging as hard as you can, as much as you can. All of us, we should be working as hard as we can. You know, what does John Wooden say about work ethic? He said, you got to bring your best when your best is required. Can anybody finish the sentence? Your best is required every day. You got to bring your best when your best is required. And people think that's the end of the sentence. But he finishes with, your best is required every day. I made a post in the group the other day. And, you know, if we judge ourselves every single day by how many sales we got, we're going to be up and down all day long. Right? So I would judge myself, you know, in the home by not whether I made a sale, but whether I made a difference, by whether I made a connection. By the way, if I didn't make a sale, did I make her happy? She was miserable. I made her happy for a couple hours. You know, I made that lady smile who probably, she hasn't really cracked a smile in probably 3 weeks or so. She told me her life story. She wrote nothing to smile about. I don't blame her for not smiling. She don't got nothing to smile about. I listened to her story. It's messed up, you know? So I didn't sell her, but man, I made her laugh, made her feel good. I let her know that there's good people out there and give her a little bit of hope. So you can't sell everybody, but you can make everybody day a little bit better, right? So on my end, if I go and I say, man, I got all these numbers I got to hit. And if I don't hit my numbers for the day, every single day, I'm going to be up and down all day, right? But if I just make myself, the goal is to grow, because if I grow, I'll eventually hit those numbers. Some of my numbers are too big. I need to grow into them. And that's fine. I'm cool with it. It's like, you know, if you bought a kid, like sometimes I'll buy my son a pair of shoes, like a half size too big. I'm not worried about it. Right? Why? I know he's going to grow into it. Right? Only thing that stops him is that plan's not going to work. If what? If he stops growing, right? It's the only plan. So we're allowed to have big goals and big numbers as long as you know you're going to grow into it and you're willing to grow into it. But sometimes growing, there's growing pains that's involved. You ever listen to Kobe Bryant? Kobe Bryant said in eighth grade, he got into this big tournament for the summer. His dad was in an MVP. His uncle was in it. He won the MVP. His grandfather won an MVP of the league. Now Kobe Bryant goes into it, and he was saying that he had to wear knee pads. Anybody remember why he had to wear knee pads? Because his knees hurt. Because he was growing too fast. He said, I had growing pains in my knees. I was growing too fast, right? So that summer, he scored no points, wore knee pads, and his knees hurt the whole time. Next summer, though, he worked super, super hard to make sure that he scored 0 points in the whole summer league. Not 1 point. Like, he can't even, like, make a layup or a foul shot. They said, he was like, nope, I couldn't put no balls in the hoop. So next summer, he went, won MVP, crushed the league, did all that, right? So you got to look at where you're at right now and where the growing pains may be and push through them. Just push through them. You know, we don't got to go through it. We're going to grow through it. You don't just got to go through it. You know, most of the time when you're going through stuff, you're not even going through it. You're growing through it. You don't even realize till you look back through it anyways. So, and one reason why I got to go through it and grow through it is because if I don't go through it and grow through it, then how can I help somebody else do the same thing if they have to go through the same thing I have to go through? You know? So in this business, if I couldn't make 1,000 phone calls a week, how can I expect anybody else to make 1,000 phone calls a week? They're gonna look at, how can I do it? I'm gonna say, well, here, I'll show you how I did it, right? So whatever our obstacles may be, it's important for us to see that we're going through it because someone else is going to be going through it someday, and they're gonna be pressed in front of you and looking at you for advice. And if you're like, man, I remember when I went through the same thing and I curled up in a ball in a corner and got paralyzed from fear and I didn't move. That's not going to help anybody, is it? I remember when I went through it and I crumbled and had a mental breakdown. Here's what I did when I went through it. I went through it. And when I came out, I was better off than before. And here's the way that I went through it. If anybody went through something with their son and having heart issues and they didn't know, it's scary. I could help them. Because I've been through it, and not only did I just like make it through it, we made it through it, and I still got my mental sanity along with it. I didn't lose my mind the whole way, you know. So, one thing that I'll just leave you with that helped me in that situation is that I don't know what the future holds, but I trust in who holds it. And you know, Marcus Smith told me that. And I'll tell you what, man, whenever you go through some stuff and you're like, man, I don't know what's going on, don't, and you can't control what you can't control. Like, if it's out of your control, think about it. My son's in the hospital. What am I going to do? I can't do nothing. I don't, that's out of my control, but I'm trying to focus on all the stuff that's out of my control. You know, that's going to cause you to have temporary mental insanity. If you try to focus on things that you can't control and you think about things you can't control and you worry about that, you're consuming yourself with a bunch of stuff that's completely out of your control, you will start to experience symptoms of temporary mental insanity. You know what I'm saying? Right? So you have to get back and say, hey, what are the things that I can't control? What are the things that I can't control? What are the things I had to focus on the things that I can control on a daily basis. And I had to tell myself, just trust in who holds it. You don't know what the future holds. You got to trust and have faith, you know? So anyways, let's talk about this real quick. For the end of the month, just think about three things. You know, where are you at right now for the month? You should know exactly where you're at for the month. Whatever your goals may be. If you're like, man, this month I needed to make 4,000 phone calls and I'm at 3,000. Right? Or I needed to collect 72 referrals and I'm at 50, right? Or I wanted to write 8,000 and I'm at 7,000. So that's what I want you to identify right now. What was your goal and where are you at right now compares to that goal? And then the second thing is, where are you going to be by Thursday? That'll be your end of the month number, your mark. And then we'll move on and we'll go crush August. August is going to be bigger and better than any month we've ever had. So just get ready. And then the last thing is, so remember, there's three things. It's where are you at? Where are you going to be by Thursday? And the last thing is, what is your plan to get there? What is your plan to get there? Talk to other people who have done it and ask them. Right, come up with your plan. Bring it in my office and run it by me real quick. and I'll even give you some pointers on it. I might just say, dude, that's the best plan I've ever seen, you know? Or I might say, dude, that's a great plan. Do you ever think about maybe adding this and it over here? Or maybe you should do this. And you'd be like, oh, wow. You know, and I could give them maybe a couple pointers. Just maybe look at it from a different perspective. You know, that's why in a football game, they have three perspectives. There's on the field. There's the captain. The captain on the field is kind of reporting back to the person who's on the sidelines. The sidelines is a whole different view, right? But the person on the sidelines has their headset on, right? And who are they talking to? The guy all the way upstairs, because there's a whole different perspective on the game, right? And I would recommend that in your business planning and throughout your month and throughout your career, always try and gain different perspectives on the game, because you're in it. You're in it. You're like the on-the-field captain. But maybe pull over, ask your GA or your MGA who's on the sidelines, or your RGA or the SGA who's up in the box looking down, and get different perspective on it. I don't know about calling the people in the Goodyear blimp, though. They're probably too far up there to give you any real opinion on what's going on in the game, okay? So what's that?
You can't call Steve Greer.
Yeah, Steve Greer probably wouldn't be able to give you too much better good perspective. But anyways, explain in detail your plan. Okay, so next, I wanted to recognize in this magazine two things. Well, one thing, first of all, look at this guy, huh? Come on, Ryan Haynes. Give it up for Ryan, huh? He is our leading. Ryan is our leading personal recruiter in our agency right now. This was recognized for hitting 5 personal recruits. He got a bronze, but he just got an email for hitting 10 personal recruits. Now he's in the silver level as far as personal recruits. Now, when you hit 15 personal recruits, you become a gold, and then let's see what it does. You become platinum at 25. 25 gets the platinum. So you get a plaque every single time. And let's see. Last month, this is for the month of May, the top personal recruiter in the company had 9. So that was for the month of May. And the top personal recruiter in the company year to date is at 24. That's Astrid Castellano. So, or Astrid Castellano. She has 27, actually, it says right here, 27 total in her career, 24 for the year. So those are the top personal recruiters in the company for chasing some of that stuff. Also, a couple things. What's the front of this thing say? Ride the wave, right? Ride the wave. What do you think that means? Yeah. You know, they say a rising tide raises all ships. Think about that. All the ships. So literally all you got to do is hop on board and ride the wave. The company best mark in March of 2020 was the best month in company history. April 2020 was the best April in company history. We did 21 million compared to 19 million from last year. 11% growth year over year date. May 2020 was the best May in company history. 21.7% growth just in the month of May, year over year, during a recession and depression. For the first time, oh, that's reinstatements. That's not too applicable. How about this? Our agent count is at 8,600 agents as a company. That's an all-time record. And we had 1,500 new people join our company, which is an all-time record right now. So that's what they mean when they say ride the wave. We're going, right? So we just got to hop on and keep this thing moving. We got to do our part as an agency to make this company great, you know, and I don't take that lightly. You know, we didn't come out here to do small things. We came out to Chicago to do something big. We broke every record in company history, so we already have the recipe to do so. And we know this isn't going to happen in a day, but if we keep doing what we're doing and everybody keeps working on a daily basis, it's not going to happen in a day, but it will happen in what we do daily. And what I was going to say before is, if our goal at the end of the day was to grow today, was to grow today, was just to be better tomorrow than I am today, every day to grow, then your numbers aren't going to matter as much because you're going to win. Like, did I win today or did I not? Well, if to make three sales, you're judging your day on, I have to make three sales today. If I don't make three sales, I'm a loser, right? Well, that's pretty harsh. But if you say, my goal today is to grow, learn something new, help someone out, do something better, be better, I think we can all accomplish that. And literally, we can win 365 days in a row. And then the numbers that you're all worried about, that's going to take care of itself because we grow. If you grow, the numbers take care of itself. You're going to grow into it. It's guaranteed you're going to grow into it. Whatever number you're trying to reach, you're going to grow into it. We just can't be silly, though. And I'm trying to be a good quarterback, but I'm spending every day on a free throw line. Make sure you're growing in the right areas. Make sense? Absolutely. Okay. So Globe Life is at an all-time high. American Income Life is at an all-time high. Our agency next month is going to be our biggest month we've ever done. The path is all math. We have to know our numbers. Are you interested or are you committed? I'll give a shout out to some people that are committed. Last week, I could even have you speak if you wanted to give everybody advice. But last week, Alex and Reich crushed it on the phones. You guys led the way with your work ethic, and you set an example and a precedence for the agency. And I just want to congratulate you guys and commend that and just recognize these guys. Give them a round of applause. Alex made 1,500 phone calls last week and booked up the biggest schedule he's had his whole entire career. Reich made 950 phone calls last week. Straight beast in it. So are you interested or are you committed? Opportunity Unlimited is there, but if you're just interested, you won't truly achieve the Opportunity Unlimited. So they do the whole thing about breakfast, right? You ever hear about a chicken? Well, you ever play chicken? What's that game, chicken? Yeah, so we're going to end on this, all right? We'll end on this, all right? So we're going to say don't be a chicken. Don't be a chicken. Why do they call it chicken? Two things run at each other, and the first one to move is what?
Chicken.
Is the chicken. That means he wasn't really committed. He wasn't really committed, right? You got to be committed. They call it a chicken because you ever say, come in the water, and they don't want to come in the water, and everybody calls that person what? Chicken. Oh, why are you being a chicken? Right? What's that mean? They're afraid. You're running at each other and you move. Why that person move? Because they're afraid, right? Commitment. Just like breakfast. They say like the chicken and the hog and the pig. Who's more committed at the breakfast? The hog. If you want to eat some bacon, how are you getting that bacon?
The hog.
He had to be pretty committed to make that sacrifice, huh? You want to eat some eggs for breakfast, what do you got to do?
Chicken.
No, you don't kill a chicken to get eggs. Vince has no clue how nature works. No.
Chicken.
Say, Vince said you got to kill the chicken to get the egg. You don't.
It's a horrible way to put it.
No, the idea, guys, is that the chicken just had to lay an egg. They didn't have to make a true sacrifice and go 100% committed in order for us to have breakfast. But the pig, no turning back on that, right? So you want to talk about killing things to get to the egg? So that's the golden goose too. You ever hear about the man with the golden goose? Man had a golden goose. The goose used to lay golden eggs for everybody, for his family, right? And you know what this guy did? He didn't have the patience. He didn't have the patience. So one day he said, I'm sick of getting one golden egg a week. He said, I'm going to go up in that goose and I'm going to just cut his head off and I'm going to go in there and I'm going to get all the golden eggs all at once. How well do you think that worked for him? All right. So that's the story on patience, right? So anyways, We watched a video the other day with my kids that Daquan posted in the group from a Navy SEAL speaking to his graduating class. And if you haven't checked that out, check that one out as well. I make my kids, screen share, like AirPlay screen share. So I put it screenplay AirPlay. We got like this 120-inch TV in my basement, and I screen share it on there, and I made them watch it before they were able to eat breakfast yesterday, you know? And the thing that jumped out to me was that he talked about that, you know, you're going to meet how many people in your life, did he say?
8,000, 10,000. 10,000.
That's right, Reich. You're going to meet 10,000 people in your life is what he said on average. Okay. Well, with this company, let's just say that you do 10 presentations a week. And you do that for a whole year. How many people are you going to meet? 500. And you do that for 10 years. You're going to meet how many? 5,000. Let's say on a weekly basis that you interview 10 people a week as well. That means you're going to interview 500 people a year and 5,000 people over the next 10 years. I can't even think of how many people that I have met and interviewed over the last 12 years with this company, plus 3 years with Ameriprise. What's cool about it is the average person out there only gets the opportunity to meet 10,000 people. If you're average, you only get 10,000. With this opportunity, over the next 10 years, you're going to meet 10,000 people just through this opportunity, not let alone going to the gas station, shopping, the malls, the clubs, all the events we're going to go to that you're normally going to meet as well. How much better at talking to people and working with people are you going to be after you've met 1,000 people, after you've met 2,000 people, after you've met 10,000 people? How much of a person, like I'm talking about developing as a human being. I just look back over the last 15 years and I've met so many people and they've touched me and I've touched them. And we've worked in so many different ways and it's made me the person that I am today. And I feel like I could talk to more people and relate to more people just because I've been exposed to and was forced to do so. So I was just thinking about that and thinking about how blessed we are to not be in an average situation where we're only going to meet 10,000 people throughout our lifetime. Us here, right? You're going to meet hundreds of thousands of people and you're going to be able to affect. Now, I don't want to meet 10,000 people. I want to meet 100,000 people and have an effect on them. Most people are just going to meet 10,000 people throughout our lifetime. We have the opportunity to meet hundreds of thousands of people and make an effect on all of them. What a big difference that's going to be. And then he used this analogy. He said, we don't need to change all 10,000 people's life. What if you only change 10? And them 10 change 10, and them 10 change 10. How many you got so far? No. No. Think about it. I changed 10, and then them 10 changed 10. So where are we at now? 100, and then them 10 changed 10.
10,000.
Is that 1,000? That's 1,000. And then them 10 changed 10. Now you're at 10,000. Them 10 changed 10. Now you're at what? 100,000, right? What? From one person, All Reich did through his whole entire life is just change 10 people lives for the better. Think about that. We're going to change way more than 10 people's lives. This Navy SEAL was excited about meeting 10,000 people and changing 10 of them. And I'm thinking, that's small potatoes. We're doing way bigger stuff over here with what we got going on. When I help somebody, if you just sell 10 life insurance policies, there you go. You already did 10 people, but way better than whoever be. So them 10 people are already set up. Now, when they pass away, their kids' lives are going to be better. And then now their kids' lives are going to be better, which is going to allow them to put themselves in a better spot instead of a worse spot. Instead of, you say, it's like starting off behind in life instead of setting off ahead. So you're going to set them off ahead, and then they're going to be able to have a better, and then they're going to be able to bring their family up to a whole nother, and generations upon generations are affected because that one family right went out on a Sunday night and met with that he didn't have to do, that he did, because he's committed, because he's not a chicken, right? So what about in this business though? You know, I was able to, you know, recruit one guy, and this one guy was able to change his life. This one girl, guy, person, just one person. Now they come into this business. They thought that there's no way they're ever going to have a chance to make professional income. There's no way their family's ever going to get out of poverty. There's no way. They've never seen it. There's no opportunities out there. Show me the opportunities, guys. How many real opportunities are there right there in America where you come in your very first year and make $100,000? Within 4 years, you could be making $1 million a year. Like, where is that possible? I would like to know. After 2 years, you can make $250,000. Like, it's just, it's a possibility. That's all I want to know. Where is it a possibility for that to even happen? There's not many. I can't think of any. We wrote down a list right now. I'm waiting for them, guys. I'll make a list of 1 to 10. Can you put them? Give me 2. Where can you quit today and 2 years from now be making? Like, I don't know. I just don't know. All I know is that's this opportunity. You know, that's what this opportunity has done for myself, my family, and many other people. So I got this person who now they have hopes, they have dreams. They actually can see it's a possibility. So now all of a sudden that person becomes a better person than they've ever been. But now because of this opportunity, it helps their family out. Now their family, instead of going down the same road that all the other families are going, now they're actually going down to a better situation. That family set up in a better life for the rest of their life. And then every generation upon generation upon generation, that family alone is set up. But now he also comes into the business. He brings in 10 people and they do the same. And they do the same, and they do the same. How many generations upon generations can we help? You know? So we're just getting started, guys. And that's why the hashtag, if you see the hashtag ever being posted for the agency, is just getting started. So keep that in mind for yourself. Every time they say, Tommy, you had a great month, I say, that's awesome. We're just getting started. Tommy, you're number one 4 years in a row in the company. That's all right. We're just getting started. Wait till you see what we do next. Hashtag just getting started, guys. That's all of us right now, right? So appreciate your time, guys. We got a big, big week to close out this month. Appreciate your hard work and effort. Let's close out strong. Thanks, guys.
Oh. Woo! Love the class.
Woo! Yeah. Oh. We'll put some music on for these.
What are you doing here? Any suggestions on some music?
Like what you like?
What's a good playlist? What's a good playlist, guys? Anybody have some good playlists?
What kind of music do you like?
Something that positive, keep us hype, but I don't really care. You can swear, though, hip hop, you know?
No,
playlist.
Oh yeah, you can play some Pop Smoke. Shake the room, shake the room.
Pop Smoke.
Yeah, you're gonna feel that.
Nah.
We're gonna blast it
for sure.
Came right up.
Oh yeah, he's very popular. I really like the way you speak, by the way, Tommy.
Oh, man, appreciate it.
I like
it. Thanks, dude. See what's going on. Yeah, we're going to get you. I mean, dude, you'll be speaking up here, you know?
Soon.
What's your boy say?
Josh.
Josh, I didn't meet him yet.
Yeah. You're going to have some competition for some calls soon.
Come on, bro.
Yeah.
Yeah, thanks, dude.
It's not perfect, but I can.
How did you fix it?
Huh?
How'd you get that up there?
Duct tape.
What?
Yo, because you guys had it right. Because when you guys put it on together, was it tipping over?
Yeah.
The net, the tension of the net, when you put the net on, it holds it together. That's all you guys had to do. I was trying to figure it out too, and then I like put it together to see how it worked. And then so,
what do you mean? Where'd you use duct tape at?
So like back here?
You got the Frank Thomas.
Thank you. Thank you. I'm Thank you. Yeah, we can just do them from here.
Yeah?
Yeah, for sure. Boom. Now I'm going to. I feel like they're cool. You know what I mean? We'll just, everybody sit in here, just turn chairs. I don't think that won't. And it won't distract me. Like, if people come in and they do the overview, it's behind them.
Right.
So it's like, it's cool. We could always put some cool, like, you know, a quote on it.
Awesome.
Like,
Welcome.
Yeah. Not like I like it. Yes, sir. But now that I'm thinking about it, it's like when I'm pitching, I kind of need a whiteboard, not a black one. You know what I mean? So that's
Who knows how it'll look on the screen. It might look pretty cool.